some scholars may say that whale is like a valley in hellfire. It's the same thing, just to show how big is really or how bad is the outcome of these practices. But again, the other question that we have to ask, who are the people? What is the profile of these people who are basically practicing this? Al-Quran saying, الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَ. The one who basically accumulated wealth. What is the relationship? These people who, are they just, I mean, anybody who accumulate wealth? Okay, what is the relationship between accumulation of wealth and these social practices? Because Quran is making the connection between them. And I will ask Brother Naji like to give us, to shed more light into what is really the relationship between really these two things, accumulation of wealth and these social practice that we talked about, humaza and lumza, hams and lums, but being practiced in a repeated fashion to the point that it becomes accepted, it becomes a second nature, if you like, of the people who are practicing them.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Maybe we can continue in the same direction, the way we were approaching the Quran. Okay. So we can look at the structure of the unit. Ayah, as we said, the ayah is the unit that has a meaning. So it's a way to approach the Quran to understand it. So what I see here, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. This is unit. And the Quran also is talk about, it's very beautiful the way he's putting it here. You'll see the relationship between one and two. So here he's putting in the plural, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. It's general, it's plural. Wow to every. The translation, I don't know, I disagree with that, but anyway, it's because the translation tried to translate it really literally. But the meaning, it's what's is very important here is what type of environment that society has. So it's try, the Quran is used here as to, it's a new way to see or to read the society. It's a new way to apply اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, as we said. So here, it's from the beginning, this is really Quran Makki and the early Makki surah. So the Muslims do not have power. But still, when you see the society in different eyes, you can see way. You can see war. You can see bad results. You can see wrong direction. So it's not really punishment. As you can see, hey, this is really very wrong direction the society is taking. And what also we know at the society also we said the relationship is parental relationship, to which tribe you belong, to which family, to which you know house, etc. Here the Quran is new relationship. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. His again is values. هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ is has that meaning to belittle people. You know, to create an environment when, as the Quran later on will use, as Fir'aun, to describe Fir'aun, استخفَ قومه فأتاعوه. You make people without weight. You know, the way, what type of teaching you will teach the society. How you teach culture that make from human being low creature. Because human beings are created to be the highest creature, to have the highest level of, to occupy the highest level in this universe to even reach a level when, you know, even angels cannot reach. And this is why we saw in Surah Inna A'tainaka Al-Kawthar, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. So it means really as you free yourself from any level you reach, so you can move to higher one. And the way the Quran put it, أَنْحَرْ. So it means really you free yourself, is you fight against it, is you kill it, you die, if you like, from one state, so you can move to higher one. But usually when you take people, belittle people, or the idea is humaza, lumaza, has that meaning, is you plant or you seed, if you like, very low concern in human being life. It is kind of a type of fashion show, if you like, type of culture. So it means what type of dress you have, what you ate today, you know, how you do your hair, you know, this kind of type of thing. So you can take human being and with wrong concern and put the whole society in the wrong direction. And that way, the second ayah, القرآن الذي جمع مالا وعدده. القرآن is not talking about plural here. It's talking about individual, is one person. So it means it's really self-interest. It's your own interest. You are very egoist, if you like. So it means you just think about yourself. And جمع مالا وعدده. Again, this is when we saw إن أعطيناك الكوثر, the new world view, is after creating a culture when things and wealth and everything in this universe become service of human being. In this type of society, the human being is used, destroyed, to be in service of things. So humaza, lumaza is really here to destroy the quality of human being, to take human being down, to belittle them. Why? Because you believe that wealth is higher value. The same thing in A'tainaka al-Kawthar, when you believe is what is here was created to serve you as human being, so you can realize higher quality of society, and a society of value, system of values in this life. So here is exactly, is very compatible. When you go to the wrong direction, when you believe you are created to serve things, and also so you will be used to accumulate things. So this type of people and this type of societies and this type of things, so جمع مالا وعددهم يحسب أن ماله أخلدهم. So his has that feeling, that has that belief, and when you keep counting, because the Quran uses the very beautiful verb yahsab. Yahsab has two things: is hasaba. Now you count, but yahsab also you think is really to save you. Is kind of you believe in wrong. Wrong thing, if you like. It's not true, because after all, you will die. As we say, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. We saw it from this first surah also. So here is الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ. So when you have that feeling, so wealth will be used for the interest of the individual. It's not really to work for better society, if you like. Doesn't matter really is how, because they are belittled, so this is the explanation. They are not smart, they are homeless because they didn't work, you know, all this.